Welcome, sir.
Good to have you with us.
Wow.
Everything you can to help to do the final push. The country is ripe, our people are receptive of the Take It Back movement, and we are glad to just share the message.
We
this is just one of the places that we know that those who are living outside of the country
just
come and engage and interact. Everywhere Nigerians want us to come, because this is preparation or preparatory. Returning back home, the glorious homeland that we can call our own, Nigeria, the land that is green, the land that is blessed, the land that has been scorched by bad leaders. We have traversed the length and breadth of Nigeria in the last few weeks, and there's nowhere that we've been that our people are not ready. So it's glad to be here with you, and very soon. We will be back home celebrating our takeover of power democratically on May 29, 2019.
All right. All right.
Another person has a question, right?
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Please, I really want to know the time you have for those of us that are living abroad. Like that confidence and the security that you are giving to us. Because like most of us are here, because of the news we hear downtown, we are scared. I mean, we don't have that security.
Yes.
So we want an assurance, I mean, a message for those of us that are living abroad.
Interestingly, I have lived abroad for 19 years myself. I live in the U.S. and I have the same concerns that you are secure if you go back home, or if you can actually not start or you keep using Nigeria to scare your children. what I can tell you is that Nigeria is terrible not because of the Nigerian nation. The Nigerian people are very friendly people. They are very happy people, as has been found out by a lot of researchers around the world. That is why they are inviting us, those of us who have seen how to be secure, to come back home and let us join hands together to make the country secure for everybody. But what is major problem in Nigeria is just a few things. Apart from just the bad nature of the leaders that have been running the place for 58 years, Nigeria is in darkness. And the moment you expel the darkness through interventionist efforts that are going to be deliberate and immediate, electricity, Nigeria will start to experience all kinds of happiness and security, and health will improve at the same time, education will improve. Because kids can actually go to bed and do their homework assignment before they go to bed. Your neighborhood will be lit enough that armed robbers cannot just walk in there in the dark and do whatever they want. Kidnappers will no longer be able to access that building. And so the rest of other things that we need to put at distance, because even for those of you who travel home for a few days, you know how hellish it can be to sleep in that place. You have no AC, you have not even a fan that is able to keep your body comfortable overnight. So what we are going back to do is not me now, I guess it's all of us, is to rescue our country, to take the country back, put those things in Nigeria, and everything will be so happy to even move back home without having to worry about security. All the security we have a corrupt police system. But there's corruption in the police level as well. We can fix that by ensuring that we train and equip proper policemen and pay them properly. And it's just all I can tell you, that when you have the right kind of leadership in place in Nigeria, you don't have to worry about money. And we can as well just, we are going to start that for next year. because who else can understand this thing better than those of us who are afraid of those things? So it will be a priority for us.
Because thank you.
Thank you.
I think we have another person who has another question, right?
Ross, ask question.
Can
you face the camera, please?
It's not a big problem. The reason we are not declaring party is that apart from other political persons or persons in the country, they are the only group of persons that are pushing the political system with the movement. And a movement, when you create a movement, is even stronger than a political party. A political party is just a paper formality in Nigeria. So many of them actually were created by the APC and the PDP. So you have to be careful. So we are growing our movement, ensuring that the movement is intact and strong, mobile, agile, and capable of taking power. When we're ready, so many political parties are rushing to us, asking us, even some young people in the APC and PDP have moved to our side.
Right.
So we're just waiting for all of that, and we will join one of the several political parties that have invited us. And then we will have others who cannot wait to just join us. So that's as simple. The reason we shouldn't worry is that as of 2014, when this new president was coming, we didn't declare political, and he wasn't a candidate until October. So we still have enough time. INEC says the submission of forms will be in August. We have a whole month and almost 3 weeks to go. And I guarantee you that we'll wrap that up. It's not a problem. If we're concerned at all, we'll be open and honest about it. We have no concern about which political party to do. The question will be, is everybody willing to move with us? That's the issue. But to be clear, we're not joining with this.
Mr. Shuret, so I know a lot of people are watching back home. What message do you have for Nigerians watching back home that are yet to obtain their PVC?
I just came back to Nigeria. I don't know many people have obtained their PVC. There is a PVC anger in the land. So the PVC is their life right now. INEC is a problem. My problem will be if INEC, my concern will be if INEC is able to cope with providing the services to people who need to get their PVC. Because we went to campuses, we went to town hall meetings and town, and everybody showing up their PVC. They are not joking with you. So, but if there's anybody out there who hasn't obtained their PVC, you are doing yourself a disservice. That's all I can say to you. Make sure you do it. And if you have any problems with INEC not providing you your authentic PVC on time, just let us know through our social media handles. You can reach us on Facebook so that we can put pressure on INEC to make sure that you can get your PVC. But for now, I think there's massive interest by Nigeria. We're surprised to see how many students have PVC. Students don't usually care about the national but high institutional students, they are walking around with their PVC. I see with their social security card. They are really, really upset with the system. People are tired and everybody is saying enough is enough.
Take it back! Take it back!
Thank you.
Our driver right here, brother, say hello to
hello.
Take it back.
We are here in Italy doing what needs to be done for the country. We hope everybody back there in Nigeria, we put on the pressure in order for us all to take it back.
And Pastor is here behind us.
Pastor, man.
Pastor, we've done enough of praying.
Mm-hmm. We should add energy back up prayer with works.
That's right.
Prayer without works, your PVC right now is a threat to the future we have been praying about. Right now, I am done playing church politics. It is time to cross the line.
That's right.
You see, I